Well, look, if you haven't heard of Led Zeppelin, you should check your genitals for weird probe marks because it probably means you've been abducted by an alien for the last 25 years. Along with the Stones and the Beatles, Led Zepp are one of the great rock and roll acts responsible for the most amazing song ever written, Stairway to Heaven. And tonight, we have with us the two men responsible for that song, the driving force behind Led Zepp, who've got together recently to record their first album in 14 years, together that is, No Quarter, an extraordinary album. Please welcome Mr. Robert Plant and Jimmy Page.
That's it then.
That's it now. It's over. Thanks very much. That was fabulous. Thank you very much. Okay. Back to me, babe. It's so nice to meet you after all these years. You've been in my head all this time, you know that.
I could feel it.
Yeah, yeah. It's been quite a scary thing. No Quarter. Let's talk about No Quarter. You've recorded a lot of this in Morocco with Nawa tribesmen. Uh-huh. Now, how do you get together? Does your agent call their agent? How does that work?
I knew a girl in a restaurant in Marrakesh.
I love stories that start like that.
And basically, one situation led to another to another. And this group were playing in the restaurant. They were amazing. Really, like, happening music. And they were just playing to people who were, like, sort of going, oh, I think I must go home now. Or they had Moroccan tummy.
Right.
And these people were playing, and they were brilliant. And we couldn't find anybody else who'd play with us. So I called a restaurant.
You couldn't find anybody else who'd play with you?
It's been a very lean.
Telling the truth,
it's been
Jimmy.
A lean 10 years.
Oh, has it really now?
Yeah.
Sure, I'm sure it has. How hard is it actually writing music with people who are diametrically culturally different to you? They don't speak your language. They probably don't have a single Led Zepp album in their collection.
Yeah, they don't have a collection.
They don't even have a collection. No. How hard is it working with that?
Well, we were really lucky, weren't we? We just went into a courtyard, sat down with them. There was all this kind of incense and stuff sort of floating around. In fact, it was a bit like Woodstock was way back.
Yeah.
And we just started playing with them.
Really?
And we had these visions, you know? It was remarkable, actually. It was really good. It didn't take very long at all.
Where do I get that incense from, actually?
Well, judging by what happened to us last time we were here, I'm not going to tell you.
What did happen to you last time you were here?
It's my attention span.
Oh, I see, yes. No, I understand. Will you please welcome Mr. Robert Plant? I'm just reminding him of who he is. And this is Jimmy Page immediately to your right.
He's a recovering candidate, all right?
Actually, we have some footage of you playing with the Nawa tribesmen in that very square. Let's check it out. Let's get a feel for it.
There's surprisingly few women in that clip.
Now, why would that be?
I can't imagine where they all went. I think they were in the caravan with Rex, our tour manager. Yeah, it was an amazing night in Marrakech. Yeah.
Because you've said you'd like to perform with...
These are not all innuendos, you know. Some of this is true.
No, this is not Julian Clary here, you know. You've said you'd like to perform with... maybe it is. With Moroccan trance singers who can teach you how to cut yourself but you don't feel it?
Well, the Jalala. There's all these different forms of music in Morocco and North Africa.
Yeah.
And really, why am I doing all the talking?
I was about to say.
Because he keeps asking you the questions.
Yeah.
Well, no, it's a thing. Okay. I'm terribly sorry.
Right. No.
Yes, tell me about the Moroccan trance musicians.
About, we'd heard stories before about the Djedjuka tribes people. And they, when they bring in the rites of spring, you know, Panathian feast, which just goes on for days and days, the stories of smashing bowls over their heads, starting to bleed. The next day, there's not a scar or a mark or anything.
It's a bit like your wet T-shirt competitions in the pubs around
here. No, we don't. This is the 90s now. We don't have those anymore. We've moved on. We have wet brain competitions instead.
Yeah, I can see that.
Thank you very much. It's gel, actually.
I think the deal is if you repeat anything long enough, something happens to you that doesn't normally happen. And the whole mantric thing with Moroccan, North African music is that the repetition of the rhythm, the riff, and the whole intention goes round and round. Like in Haiti, you're probably more familiar with it in Haiti.
Yeah, that's where the shamans in Tibet do the same thing.
That's
where
they
work themselves up into this state where they believe they can see ghosts.
Yeah. We were only there for about 2 hours. So we only got a certain amount of it.
Yeah. You
know, just enough for two songs.
Well, you said that the music you did in Morocco is about as far away from George Michael as you can get. Has this been a career ambition for you?
Well, a friend of mine's got his coat. It's a sort of powder blue, sort of worsted. We're on our way anyway.
If we can
find a chorus now, we'll have a hit.
Jimmy, one thing that amazes me, the double neck guitars and also the triple neck guitars, mm-hmm. I don't see how that works because you can only play one at a time.
I know. But not in Morocco, maybe. Maybe you can visualise more.
No. Oh, I see. So it's
no,
just
they're
a
in different tunings. That's what it is.
So
it's not that technical, believe me.
It really, because I've often wondered if it's actually a show business thing or if it's the real thing.
No, it's a real thing.
So you really
sure.
Get...
Sure. I'm getting one made up with eight necks. I'm going to get a wheelwright to make a big rim round it, and then I can do car wheels off the stage.
That is... Now that is rock and roll.
Yeah, I think so.
Of course, on No Quarter, you've reworked a number of Zep classics. You've got Kashmir, Four Sticks, Gallows Pole, but there is one classic that's not there.
Well, I think you flogged that to death already.
I think flogged is an unfair...
I like the word flogged.
I think... That's very British Conservative Party of you, Robert. I think that is an unfair thing.
I don't like David Mellor, but I like the word flogged.
We pay tribute to this song, and in fact, I'd just like to remind
Tribute.
You...
Tribute? I thought you were on a royalty.
No, I wasn't. That's how stupid I was. I wasn't on a royalty. No, I just want to remind you of what a tribute we paid. Feast your eyes.
There's a lady who's sure all that glitters is gold, and she's buying a stairway to heaven.
There's a lady who's sure all the glitters is gold.
There's a lady.
Oh, yeah. Are they still in the business?
Who is that lady? If you examine the text of this piece, then you find that lady is none other than Miss Shirley Bassey.
Oh, it makes us wonder.
There's a lady who knows all that glitters is gold, and she's buying a stairway to heaven.
What more tribute could you pay?
I think you missed the best one.
Which was that?
The Fat Elvis. I thought he was fantastic.
No sooner do you say it, then here it is in front of your very eyes.
Where is he?
Cue
is he
Elvis.
There's a lady who the leaders go. She's fine, but stay away, you have when she gets there, she knows that the stores are open. With the words, she can get what she came for. There's a sign, but she wants to be shot.
Why is that your favourite?
Well, when I was a kid, I used to hide behind the curtains at home at Christmas, and I used to try and be Elvis. There was a certain ambiance between the curtains and the French windows. There's a certain sound there for a 10-year-old. That was all the ambience I got at 10 years old. I think. And I always wanted to be certain, a bit similar to that, you know, but I didn't want to sell pizza.
No, but it's so easy to be Elvis now, of course.
Yeah, I know, I've been watching some of your TV.
Now, tell me the truth. When Rolf Harris went to the top of the charts in England with Stairway to Heaven, what did you think? This was the sign of the Antichrist?
Well, you know, they wouldn't... Oh, no, I've... You know, some of my best childhood memories have been watching Rolf.
Wow.
Yeah. Now, you know they wouldn't put it out in America because there was such disdain. Everybody was absolutely furious.
Really?
Yeah, there was a lot of... don't worry, Rolf, just keep on snoring back there.
What did you guys think? Were you furious or were you amused?
I didn't really hear it. No, I'll tell you the truth. It was when I got a whole... I didn't know he'd gone to the top of the charts. I was abroad at the time working.
Right.
But I did get a whole set of clips of all that, and I thought it was hilarious.
All right. Yeah.
I think he's great, Rolf.
Yeah, of course he is.
I don't care what he, you know...
Plus, he can do Jake the Peg and we can't.
Yeah. Which one for your next album? Now, before we go, Robert, I have to ask you, what does If There's a Bustle in Your Hedgerow mean?
You've got me in over a barrel now, or under a barrel.
I never touched him.
Cheers. No. Shall I tell him No, I won't tell you the Freudian thing, but what it is, it's the beginning of spring, it's when the birds make their nests, when hope and the new year begins, and it's nothing to do with any of the weird stuff you've read about in America.
Oh, right.
Yeah. So it's the beginning of the new year.
Thank God, now we all know. Yeah. Now you're going to play for us tonight, what are you going to play?
There's a bustle in your hedgerow, yeah.
Excellent.
All in right. F.
Jimmy,
in
what F. does your symbol mean?
Hey?
What was that?
Symbol mean on...
The oh, symbol, no. Recovering Catholic.
It means frying tonight.
Oh, that's right. Oh, I see.
Thank you very much for that question from the audience. Will you please thank Robert Plant and Jimmy
Page. Sorry we
don't
respond to all those.
Thank you, guys.